So welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about heat transfer by means of conduction part 1, in which we are going to discuss about thermal conductivity, effect of variation of temperature on thermal conductivity, as well as we are going to derive the most general equation in Cartesian coordinate system for heat transfer by means of conduction. Friends, in the last video, we had discussed about mode of heat transfer, and the link for the same is mentioned in the description box. So you can refer the various mode of heat transfer, and now we are going to discuss about heat transfer by means of conduction, in which first we will discuss about the very important property called thermal conductivity. So thermal conductivity is a property of material, and if the material possesses a higher thermal conductivity, means it is a good conductor of heat, and if the material possesses lower value of thermal conductivity, means it is a poor conductor of heat transfer, or you can say it is a very good insulator for the heat transfer. The thermal conductivity, which is a property of material, is depend upon the following factor, that include operating condition, that is temperature and pressure, density of the material, moisture content, as well as material structure. The unit of thermal conductivity is watt per meter degree Celsius or watt per meter Kelvin. Now you can refer the table in which you can see the diamond is possessing the highest value of thermal conductivity, that is around 2300 watt per meter Kelvin, but diamond is not an engineering material. So you can say silver is the engineering material which possesses the highest value of thermal conductivity, and that value is around 430 watt per meter degree Celsius or watt per meter Kelvin. Next to silver, you can see copper is the material which possesses thermal conductivity value around 385 watt per meter degree Celsius. In the same way, you can find the thermal conductivity for the water, for the gases, for air. Thermal conductivity of the material which is available in the solid phase possesses the highest value of thermal conductivity, then the liquid phase will come. Now we have to discuss a very important topic, that is what is the effect of variation depend upon two part, that is migration of free electron as well as lattice vibration. So you can heat is supplied to the solid. The free electrons which are available in the electron cloud, they will start create obstruction in the path of flow of free electron. So with a rise in the temperature, you can see that it higher temperature or with rise in the temperature, the thermal conductivity of pure metal decrease with increase in the temperature. But the exceptional cases include the uranium, mercury and aluminium, for which thermal conductivity will rise with rise in the temperature. You can see the graph of temperature variation with thermal conductivity. You can see here for the copper, for the gold. You can see with rise in the temperature, the thermal conductivity drops. But as we had discussed for the aluminium, with rise in the temperature, thermal conductivity missile purpose. In that case, the aluminium will play an active role during coking, and that is very harmful to our health. So generally it is not desirable to use aluminium utensils for cooking purpose. The same way when we'll talk about alloys, then alloys are combination of pure metals, and generally what happens in the metal, same is repeated for the alloys also, because it is made up with more than one metals. So the thermal conductivity for pure thermal conductivity in case of alloys, that will decrease with rise in the temperature. Now if we'll talk about effect of thermal conductivity with variation on temperature in case of insulating material, you can see for the insulating material, in the insulating material some void or space is there, and in that space or void some air or gas is trapped. Because with this thermal conductivity of air or gas which is trapped into this insulating material, that will increase. And because of that, generally with rise in the temperature, thermal conductivity of insulating material, that will increase. So with you can say that for generally all the insulating material for refrigerating, but the magnesite bricks are exceptional case in which the thermal conductivity will not increase with rise in the temperature, and because of that only this magnesite bricks are used as a brick for the furnace in case of boiler, or as and when higher temperature is required we have to use that material, because in that case there is with increase in the temperature. Okay friend, now we are interested to know what is the effect of variation in exceptional cases. The reason behind this is the physical mechanism of heat conduction in liquid is also will decrease with rise in the temperature. But you can see in the graph for the water, we can observe that now friend, in case of gases, the thermal conductivity is directly proportional to under root of temperature with increase in the temperature. And because of that, we had discussed that in case of refractory, in case of building material, gases, and because of that, the insulating material will. You can see the graph of effect of temperature on the thermal conductivity for gases. You can see for all the gases including hydrogen, helium, steam, carbon dioxide, air, freon 12, the thermal conductivity will rise with rise in the temperature, and the range of thermal conductivity for liquid varies between 0.1 to 0.7 watt per meter Kelvin. Whereas the thermal conductivity range for gases, that will be between 0.006 to 0.1. Now friend, we have to discuss the most general equation in Cartesian coordinate system for heat transfer by means of conduction. So now friends, we know that there are two different type of material. One is known as the isotropic material and one is known as the anisotropic material. So what is isotropic material? If the directional properties of the material are same और इक्वेटोरियल, दैट इज थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी इज इन एक्स डिरेक्शन, इन वाई डिरेक्शन एंड इन जेड डिरेक्शन रिमेन सेम. वेर एज इन केस ऑफ एनिसोट्रॉपिक मटेरियल द डिरेक्शनल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द मटेरियल आर डिफरेंट और अनइक्वल इन ऑल द डिरेक्शन. लाइक kx, that is thermal conductivity in x direction, is not equals to the thermal conductivity in y direction, and that is also not equals to the thermal conductivity in z direction. So whenever we are going to derive the most general equation, we have to consider the anisotropic material for which the directional properties are not same in all the direction. And for slab having Cartesian coordinate, and we are considering a very small rectangular wall with the size of dx, dy and dz parallel to the three axes, that is x, y and z direction, for anisotropic material as shown in the next figure. So friend, you can see the figure that is z. The left side is having the face ABCD and the right side is having the face EFGH. The thickness in x, y and z direction are dx, dy and dz. The heat influx is qx in the x direction, and at distance x plus dx the heat efflux is qx plus dx. In the similar direction, the heat influx is qi and heat efflux is qy plus dy. Similar to that, in the z direction, heat influx is qz and heat efflux is qz plus dz. Inside the system, heat is generated and that value is qg, that is equals to small qg into dx, dy, dz. These are some nomenclature related to this figure, which is talking about elemental volume for Cartesian coordinate system. So now we are again repeating that nomenclature in detail in the next slide. So you can see temperature, that is T, that stands for uniform temperature on the left face of ABCD, and it is a very small volume. dT by dx is the temperature gradient in x direction. Unit is degree Celsius per meter. dx is the dimensional thickness of element in x direction. Unit is meter. M is a mass of element in kg. Rho, that is the density of material in kg per meter cube. A, that is the cross section area of the element that is normal to the direction of heat flow, that is meter square. C is the specific heat of the material, unit is joule per. Del T by del x into dx, that is a change of temperature through the dx in the x direction. And T plus del T by del x into dx, that is the temperature at the face EFGH of the rectangular wall in x direction. Similarly, you can consider T plus del T by del y into dy for y direction and T plus del z for z direction. Kx, Ky and Kz are thermal conductivity of material direction. As we had assumed anisotropic material, Kx is not equals to Ky and unit is watt per meter degree Celsius. Qg, that is heat generated in unit time. Small q dot g, that is heat generated per unit volume per unit time. Unit is watt per meter cube. And hence you can say capital Qg, that is equals to heat generated in unit time, that is equals to q dot g, that is heat generated per unit time per unit volume into volume of rectangular wall. And the last term d tau, that is the elemental time duration, that is in second. So these are some nomenclature we have to use for this derivation part. So now we have to complete this analysis in three part. So first part, you can see the when we'll go for this energy balance, we have to go according to the first law of thermodynamics, and the first part is net heat accumulation from all the direction into this element, that is our part A, plus internal heat generated into the element, that is part B, and heat stored into the element, that is part C. So we have to derive this equation in three part, part A, part B and part C, and at the end we have to go for A plus B, that is equals to C, and we will get the generalized equation. So now let Q dash, that is equals to Q into D tau, that is total heat flow in the given direction for a small given value of time D tau, and the unit of Q dash, that is kilojoule. So now we start derivation for most general equation. So we are talking about part A, that is the net heat accumulation from all the direction into this element. So initially we will consider only x direction, and we will try to derive the formula for part A in x direction. So you can assume Q dash x, that is the total heat flow in the x direction from the left side of the rectangular wall, that is we are talking about phase A, B, C, D, in the time interval d tau, that is called heat influx, that is heat entering into the element. In the same way, when we are talking about Q dash of x plus dx, that is heat efflux, that is heat coming out from the phase E, F, G, H. And the value of Q dash x and Q dash x plus dx, that we have to find out. So the Q dash x, according to the Kirchhoff law, that is at the phase of ABCD, that is equals to minus kx, that is thermal conductivity in x direction, into dy dz, that is the cross section area, that is area perpendicular, we are talking about x direction, so the perpendicular area is y and z, into del t by del tau, that is temperature gradient direction, into d tau, that is our considered time. So q dash x, that is equals to minus kx dy dz into del t by del x plus d tau, that is value of Q dash x, and Q dash x plus dx, that is equals to Q dash x plus del by del x of Q dash x dx. Now the value of Q dash x in the equation 6 is available with us. We have to put that value in the equation 7 and we have to go for simplification. So you can see the total heat accumulation in the x direction, that is dq dash x, that is equals to heat influx minus heat efflux. So influx is q dash x and efflux is q dash of x plus dx. So you can say dq dash x, that is equals to q dash x minus in the square bracket q dash x plus del by del x q dash x into dx. So upon simplification, we will get that value is minus del by del x q dash x into dx. And we know what is the value of q dash x, so we have to put that. So we will get d q dash x, that is equals to minus del by del x into square bracket minus kx dy into dz into del t by del x into d tau, square bracket complete, into dx, and hence the value which will obtain in x direction is into kx del t by del x into dx dy dz and d tau, that is equation number 8 in x direction. In the similar way, if you go for y and z direction, we'll get dq dash y, that is del by del y ky into del t by del y into dx dy dz d tau. And for z direction, it is dq dash z, that is equals to del by del z into square bracket, you can say kz into del t by del z, bracket complete. Of these three equation, equation number 8, 9 and 10, we'll get part A, that is heat, net heat accumulation in all the direction into the material. So we'll get the part A, that is equals to del by del x into kx into del t by del x plus del by del y ky into del t by del y plus del by del z kz into del t by del z dx dy dz and d tau, that is equation number 11, that is our part A. So now part A is available with us, that is net heat accumulation in all the direction, that is in x, y and z direction. Now we have to move towards part B. So total heat generated within the wall Q dash G, that is equals to part B, and that is equals to Q dash G, that is equals to QG into dx dy dz d tau. So this is internal heat generation problem. So whenever there is a curing of cement, or whenever there is availability of electric conductors or wire, whenever the combustion process is going on, or when the fuel rods of nuclear reactors are available, definitely internal heat generation will be there, and we have to consider that part. And now we are moving towards part C, that is energy stored into the material or energy stored into that small element C, that is equals to mCp delta T, and that m, that is you can say density into volume. So you can say C value, that is equals to rho, that is density into volume, that is dx dy dz into C, that is specific heat, into del T by del tau, that is variation of temperature with time, into d tau. So this is our part C, equation number 13. So when we'll go for A plus B equals to C, we'll get our most general equation in Cartesian coordinate system for anisotropic material. So now all the three equations are available, and we'll go for addition of that three equations. So upon addition, you can see we'll get the equation in which on both the side, the equation number 14, that is del by del x into kx del t by del x plus del by del y qg by k, sorry, qg, that is equals to rho c into del t by del tau, that is the most general equation in Cartesian coordinate, homogeneous anisotropic material with internal heat generation under unstable condition. So we have to remember this equation number 14, which is a most general equation for heat transfer by means of conduction, and equation number 15 is represented using vector. Now in the most general equation, when we are applying certain anisotropic material where thermal conductivity in x, y and z direction remains same, in that case kx equals to ky equals to kz, and that is equals to k. So our equation number 14, that will be reduced to del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square plus del square t by del z square plus qg by k, that is equals to 1 by alpha del t by del tau, or that is equals to rho c by k into del t by del tau, where alpha, that is equals to k upon rho c, that is called thermal diffusivity, and it is a ratio of thermal conductivity to heat capacity, and its unit is meter square per second. So very important term, alpha, that is thermal diffusivity, is a ratio of thermal conductivity to the heat capacity, unit is meter square per second. Now we are going to discuss significance of thermal diffusivity. So thermal diffusivity is a ratio of thermal conductivity to heat. Means more amount of heat is stored or absorbed by the material, and hence very less amount of heat is available. Amount of heat is available for the heat transfer, and hence less temperature difference is observed. Means delta T value is small. So if larger is the value of thermal diffusivity, that is because either higher value of thermal conductivity, or you can say lower value of heat capacity, or both. In that case, more will be the heat diffused to the material, and because of that, its temperature will change with time. So if higher is the value of alpha, more temperature variation is observed. So the thermal diffusivity for metal and gas is almost same, because for metal all the values are it higher side, whereas for all the gases all the values of K, rho and C are at lower side. So you can say that for solids K value is high, rho value is high and C value is high. For the gases K, rho and C, that is specific heat, all the values are lower. So the ratio is almost same. And for all the non-metallic solids and liquids, the thermal conductivity responds slowly to the temperature change with time. And you can see the equation number 16, that is equation shown with vector operator for Laplacian vector operator delta square. So now we know the motional equation in Cartesian coordinate system under unsteady state condition in all the three dimensions, that is del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square plus del square t by del z square plus qg by k, that is equals to 1 by alpha del t by del tau. So in that equation, when we apply the assumption that there is no source of internal heat generation, means the term qg by k is 0. In that case, our equation is reduced to equation number 17, that is del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square plus del square t by del z square, that is equals to 1 by alpha del t by del tau, which is known as the Fourier's equation. In the same way, when we are applying modification in the motional equation in the Cartesian coordinate system, and when we are assuming that there is a steady state heat transfer, in that case the last term del t by del tau, that will be 0, and our equation is reduced to del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square plus del square t by del z square plus qg by k, that is equals to 0, and that is also known as Poisson's equation. Now in the most general equation, when we assume that there is no source of internal heat generation as well as there is a steady state heat transfer, in that case the motional equation is reduced to del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square plus del square t by del z square equals to 0, and that is Laplace equation. So in the similar way, you can see here different equations are shown here, where you can say in the equation number 23, we are assuming that the steady state one dimensional heat transfer. In that case, when we are talking about steady state, the term del t by del tau is 0, as well as one dimensional heat transfer means you can say only x direction is available, y and z direction is not available. So our equation is reduced to del square t by del x square plus qg by k, that is equals to 0. In the same equation, when we'll assume no source of internal heat generation is available, equation number 23 is reduced to del square t by del x square equals to 0, that is our equation number 24. Now if we assume that steady state two dimensional heat transfer without internal heat generation, in that case steady state means del t by del tau is 0, two dimensional means x and y terms are available, without internal heat generation means qg by k term is 0, and hence our equation is available with the value of del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square equals to 0. In the similar way, if we go for unsteady state one dimensional heat transfer without internal heat generation, in that case, unsteady state means the term del t by del tau is available. One dimensional means one term in x direction is available. Without internal heat generation means the term Qg by K is 0. So our equation is reduced to del square t by del x square, that is equals to 1 by alpha del t by del tau. That is our equation number 26. So this is the way how we can derive different equation for one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional, with or without internal heat generation, with or without steady state. So this is about the most general equation in Cartesian coordinate system. So friend, we had discussed about what is called thermal conductivity, what are the parameters on which thermal conductivity is depend, what is its unit, what is the range in case of solid, liquid and gas, what is effect of variation of temperature on thermal conductivity, and at the end we derive the most general equation in Cartesian coordinate system, that is in x, y, z coordinate system. If you like this channel, do not forget to subscribe, like and share this channel among your friends. So in next video we will discuss about derivation of most general equation for spherical and cylindrical coordinate system, and based on that we will discuss different theory related to heat transfer by means of conduction. Stay tuned with this channel. Have a nice day. Thank you.